After months of radio silence, Solo has finally burst onto the scene. The new Star Wars story is the first of Disney's spin-off films set to explore the life of an original trilogy character, in this case the smuggler Han Solo, played for the first time by Alden Ehrenreich. Between the Super Bowl teaser and the first trailer, there's a lot to digest. Here are a few details you might have missed. New duds. Han Solo having more or less the same costume in the original three Star Wars movies and The Force Awakens made many fans assume they would be seeing young Solo sporting the exact same look in a standalone film. But that's not the case. In the Solo trailer, the young pilot is instead sporting a wide variety of interstellar fashions. New ships. The end of the trailer provides one of the most striking images yet from the new Star Wars movies. A Star Destroyer in a dense nebula dispatching some TIE fighters in pursuit of the Millennium Falcon. While we don't know the names of these new ship models yet, you can see that there's an extra laser shooting pod to the side of the cockpit, presumably for extra firepower. New locale. While the trailer doesn't identify exactly where in the galaxy this chase is taking place, speculation is already swirling that the pursuit may be set near the cloudy area of Kessel, which according to the extended universe is surrounded by a cluster of black holes. It stands to reason that those opaque gases would be dangerous to navigate and would make any ship passing through it hard to detect. Key attributes for, say, a smuggler's route. That's why many fans are speculating that this footage could be the famous Kessel Run, which Solo made in just 12 parsecs, not 14, as Rey claims in The Force Awakens. New droid. If you've been combing through these clips looking for actress Phoebe Waller-Bridge, look no further. She plays this charming droid, L337, who seems to be the Millennium Falcon's co-pilot. She doesn't speak in the trailers, so the tone of the droid is still unknown. She definitely seems to be one of the good guys, and even has a nice little synchronized salute with Lando, played by Donald Glover. New Falcon. How many times did you have to watch the trailer before you realize this bright clean hallway belonged to the Millennium Falcon? By the time Luke comes on board the ship in A New Hope, the place looks positively grimy. Fans knew Solo would show us how the smuggler acquired the iconic vessel, but who knew it looked like it was straight off the assembly line? New baddies. Han Solo goes literal space cowboy in his first adventure, facing down a squad of bad-looking bandit dudes with nothing but his famous blaster at his side. Exactly where this showdown is taking place is still a very hidden detail, but he's certainly not fighting the Empire here. This encounter is outlaw on outlaw, and it looks like the same baddies take on Han on top of a train at one point in the film. New genre. The new trailer also provides audiences their first look at Tandy Newton, playing a gun-toting, no-nonsense lady named Vol. She's introduced in a brief clip while Woody Harrelson's space pirate Tobias Beckett is talking about getting a team together. Director Ron Howard has previously described Solo as a heist movie, though we don't know yet what's being stolen and why. From the look of Newton's gigantic gun, her character is probably what you'd call the muscle. New critter. The trailer also features a blink-and-you'll-miss-it appearance by this little creature, a four-armed space monkey piloting some heavy machinery. It's hard to guess just how this alien critter will figure into the story, but considering the dingy environment, it looks like he might be messing around in the spice mines of Kessel, doing some dirty work with some sort of monkey-sized machinery. New partner. Here we see Emilia Clarke's mysterious Kira sitting side by side with Han traveling through what appears to be an Imperial base while enemies follow in hot pursuit. In our first glimpse of Kira in the teaser and in all her red cape glory in the trailer, she appeared to be a straight-laced, stylish figure of authority. But here she looks like an outlaw, the Bonnie to Han's Clyde. Does he romance her out of an Imperial position of authority, or has she always been a scoundrel at heart? Either way, she's definitely on the run, but she's got luck on her side. Check out Han's gold dice hiding in plain sight. Thanks for watching. Click the Looper icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love too.